Anime studios typically use third-party plugins like OLM Smoother for After Effects in order to turn these pixelated colored cells into the finished animations you see on screen now. Now, I don't use OLM Smoother and I don't have After Effects, so I found a brilliant Clip Studio Paint auto action that does a similar effect, and it can be done in-app in CSP. Here's how you can achieve this effect. Now, I know what you're thinking. Why the heck are they using pixelated lines? Why don't they use this software, Toon Boom Harmony, vector lines, auto actions, blah blah blah? And to that I say, historically, Japanese anime studios will scan their paper keyframes and in-betweens into a software like RETAS PaintMan, which will digitize the lines into these pixelated or aliased lines. That way they are able to be easily colored in using a paint bucket tool. Like, look at the difference between coloring in a line like this versus coloring in a line like this. Clearly, with the quote-unquote pixelated lines, you are able to fill in the entire drawing without having to worry about gaps in the colors. Then once everything is colored in, they will blur the lines later on in the compositing process, again with software like OLM Smoother that I mentioned earlier. This is how I replicate this process within Clip Studio Paint. Credit to Nicca Ch, they actually have a CSP auto action that does this exact process. First, I have the lineart with black lines, and the color trace lines which are separated. This is for the highlights and the shadows. Next, I color in the flat colors on a layer in between the black lineart and the color trace lines. Notice how there are no transparent gaps in the color. If you want to only have the transparent cell, you can also uncheck the white background. Next, to blur the lines, all you have to do is create a new layer on top of your drawing, merge visible to new layer, and then go to filter, blur, smoothing, and there you go. Your finished animation is ready to go. Do keep in mind that if you are doing this entire process in Clip Studio Paint, you have to do this for every single frame that you draw. And so the more frames that you do, the more work you have to do. I would highly recommend making an auto action of your own or using Nicca Ch's auto action. Link in the description. And that is essentially how you can replicate blurring the pixelated lines in Clip Studio Paint.